covering my case is a smart move because what I'm about to share with you is disgusting and embarrassing. But it's me. It's like 2 in the morning and I had to do laundry because I'm sick and I shit my bed. Wow. If I ever don't know comment fame. I don't get a bunch of like 2-year-olds being like, fame, I shit the bed too. Like old people being like, yep. But yeah. There's no worse feeling than waking up and realizing you shit the bed. Like, shitting yourself in general is just a horrible thing. But my stomach is just... It's horrible. Like, I always have diarrhea or stomach problems. And I guess I'm literally sick and tired. Okay, I'm gonna stop, okay? That wasn't funny. Someone will find that funny. Maybe like a 12-year-old. My 11-year-old sister would probably roll her eyes and be like, no, you're supposed to be an adult. But anyway. I was gonna say something about the sassy black lady that lives in my soul. But we'll leave Lucretia alone. Which, oddly enough, is the name of a Mexican lady that used to be my boss. I mean, I thought that was weird too, that one of my bosses had the same name as one of my imaginary friends that live. Well, I don't know if she lives in my soul or my head, or she's just an embodiment of what I think. I don't know. I think we all have a sassy black woman living inside of our souls. She's inside us all. Anyway, I'm probably delirious from the fever I have. So yeah. That's probably why I'm making this video, because I'm dying. My body's shutting down and I'm just delirious. Oh. But yeah, so that's my update. Oh, and by the way, like, the underwear I was wearing was not the kind of underwear you want to be wearing when you shit yourself. Like, you don't want to shit yourself. But if you do, you want, like, granny panties that are gonna hold it in so it doesn't get everywhere. Because, like... I had to take my sheets and everything off. I have a little... fever rag. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I'm sure... I hope I don't wake my parents up and they're like, hey, you awake talking to yourself again. And they'll be like, you know me. I've been your daughter for 21 years. You should know that I wake up at random times and just feel myself talking to myself. So, you could all just call me Poop That Runs Like a River. That's a good Indian name, right? I apologize to all the Native American friends and Native Americans in general for that. Once again, I would like to point out, I have a really high fever, and I'm shitting my guts out, so, yeah, it's not my fault. It's like every white person that's ever offended anyone, it's not my fault, I have a fever, and religion, and I'm shitting myself. Because, like, having, like, 2% of Native American in you doesn't mean you can make jokes like that. I think it's 2%. Maybe it's lower. It's like 0.0%. I don't even know if you guys can hear me. I'm being super quiet, and I'm just a mouth and a nose right now. Or maybe just nostrils. I don't know. Anyway, it's been 7 minutes. I think I should stop and just get some Pepto-Bismol and like a whole gallon of it and drink it. But, like, I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired all the time. Especially my weird stomach problems where I just get bouts of horrible diarrhea. Just explosive diarrhea all the time, just randomly. Or I'm super constipated for like a month. That's just the IBS life. My bowels don't like me. They're so temperamental. Anyway, enough about my shit. I have a fever, okay? I'm dying. I can make all the horrible jokes I want. Anyway, I'm going to rewatch this and count all the times I mentioned my ass and the stuff that comes out of it. Fecal matter. I'm sure that's like 100 by now. Or at least like double digits. So, bye.